Okay, I think we're all in agreement that this was a great rhythm dance competition.
Oh my goodness, so many moments. And a highlight for me, of course, was Gabriella and Guillaume. They transported me. I felt like it was art, it was poetry, it was everything ice dance should be.
Yeah, I felt myself getting a little emotional, especially as they pushed through to the end of that program. We talked a lot in the lead out about everything that was stacked up against them. They hadn't been on Olympic ice in the team event. They hadn't competed in years, and they just threw that aside and had the performance of the night.
Well, they had a world record score, and certainly they were in a league of their own. Then sitting in second place, the Russian team of Tsitsina Katsalapov, and they were good. They sit 2 points back.
They did have the tough task of following Gabriella and Guillaume, but I thought it was a different class of skating, if I'm being honest. I'm a little bit scratching my head. I wish I understood a little bit more how they're so close. I thought Gabriella and Guillaume had a legendary performance at 90 points, and then they're sitting in 88 points. And ahead of teams, in particular Hubble and Donahue, that I thought outperformed them, outskated them. So a little bit of a confusion for me. Some of those marks I know are technical, but even in the second mark, I would have given the bump to the Americans.
And you liked Hubble and Donahue. You were excited by it.
Oh, it was precise. It was powerful. It told a story beginning to end. I loved every single moment, the nuances. I felt something. I really felt an emotional connection to that. I felt a crescendo of the program. And it was great to see them sort of commit until the very end. Sometimes we see them drop off, and Sometimes the mental focus just isn't always there, and they seemed really on point.
That was going to be my exact point. Like, yeah, he's a tall skater. He's so powerful. Sometimes at the end of his performances, he lets it drag. That wasn't the case today.
And no sloppiness.
Yeah, nothing at all. And I was really, really surprised. It still am that they weren't rewarded more for that.
And then you have this group of four teams that are about a point and a half separate right now of fourth through seventh place. One of those teams, the Canadians, Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier, they're in a tough spot. They're not in that final flight. They finished in sixth place in the rhythm dance, so they're not in the final flight. What does that mean?
I think the free dance is their bread and butter, honestly. So I think, yes, they're not in that top warm-up group, but that's not such a big deal. They're really tied for fourth with two other teams. It's going to come down to the free. They didn't have the short today, but it's what pressure they faced in such a thick event. They knew one little mistake, and we did see that on their face a little bit. I expect them to come out guns blazing.
Okay, so look at the standings. Papadakis and Cizeron with that 2-point lead over Tsitsina and Katsalapov. And the other Canadian teams, Lawrence Fournier, Boudry, and Nikolai Sorensen in 8th. Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga in 13th place. And we don't know what's going to happen in the free dance, but we can tell you we will, crown a new Olympic champion.
Don't be sorry.
Great.